Hey, this is Kayla Tabish.
And Nick Liam Heaney.
And you're watching Actors Reporter with Kirk Kelly for Live Video Inc.
I'm Kurt Kelly for Actors Reporter and Live Video Inc. from the 2013 AFM convention. I'm kind of staring at you because I'm trying to remember how long ago was the last time I saw Kayla.
Yeah, the infamous New York Times handshake.
It's that handshake that's been everywhere. Here, let's do it. Quick, take a picture. Yeah. When it was the screening of your first film, I believe it was, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was the theatrical opening. So we had done like the festival circuit for the year, and then we got picked up for limited theatrical release. So we did like the Lamley Theaters local.
Mm-hmm. And that was Lauren Cass?
Lauren Cass, yeah.
But that was your first film also, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was my very first.
I was there for her first film. And now you're working with Nick on what? And hello, Nick.
Hey, Kurt. How's it going? Thanks for having us on.
Absolutely.
Yep.
You're not from Cleveland, are you?
No, I'm actually not from Cleveland.
Des Moines now. Where from?
I'm from Newcastle, England. So
I was almost close, not.
Yeah, and we just finished shooting a film in the summer. It's a fantasy film.
The two of you.
The two of us. We met on the film.
So you're here promoting your fantasy now.
That's right.
Okay,
that's
good.
Right. Malcolm McDowell from Clockwork Orange. And Ernie Hudson from Ghostbusters.
Really?
And it's like two parallel worlds and how they coexist, and Kayla actually is she played the lead.
Okay.
So it was a great experience to work with Malcolm and Ernie on that film, and now we're in post and getting ready to do the next one. So.
And who's distributing this one?
That's what we're here at AFM.
I see. We're here to go up and see. We'll talk about that in a minute. And you're working on another project together?
Mm-hmm.
You guys couldn't get enough on the first one?
Well, now we're producing partners.
I see.
So
now
the relationship kind of started on the film, and then now it's progressing to producing partners.
So what's the next film about?
It's called Zero Day. It's a political thriller action.
Right.
It's based on actual events. It's about like the first ever computer virus that was used to infiltrate into like our foreign enemies, such as Iran.
No, we did that?
Absolutely.
Shock, yes.
Based on actual events. And then there's a narrative story that's fictional based around that.
So this actually wasn't started by MI6?
That's a question for you.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah, you brought that up. No, it was MI5. What's the difference between MI5 and MI6? I just became aware there's a 5.
Well, 5's very top secret.
I see. The 6 is what we let people know about in the Bond films.
That's
and
right.
The other one you have to find about.
Yeah, that's under
PBS,
the rug.
Yes.
That's right.
So how has it been working together for the first time and now continuing this relationship?
It's been pretty good.
Yeah.
I feel like whatever I don't possess, he does. So it's really, like a really symbiotic, it's great kind of business relationship in that perspective that, you know, he brings in a lot of like talent relationships, and then I have a little bit more of like the funding structure, and so together we make...
And just being able to pool all our resources just to get this film made. We're actually doing a 4-film slate. Starting in 2014, and we're looking at doing 4 pictures in 2 years.
And what budget range?
Between 1 and 3 for each film. So we're looking at a slate financing of 15 mil, and that way we can get cooking and do, you know, 4 pictures within that time, rather than it taking us 4 years to do it. We'll be able to do, you know, 4 exciting projects in 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what we're working towards now.
Do you already have the 4 projects locked down? Or
well, we've optioned one script where we've got 3 on the bubble, and that's what we're trying to solidify. So
3 on the bubble, does that mean or?
That we're considering. We're more or less going to have like a pool of anywhere from 3 to 10 projects that the investors can kind of like have a hand in and help choosing in that process of what is going to be slated. But one's option and in the process of being packaged. We have Malcolm McDowell attached in writing for that one as well. And then we're in talks with several A, B list talent and kind of parlay that. So it's that much more lucrative for the investor.
Now, are these films going to be more domestic appeal or international appeal or both?
I think to be candid and honest, like with that budget range, foreign is pretty much where you get your bread and butter.
Right.
Of course, we would love to have you know, those little stories where you hear about like the micro budget films that do so well domestically and get a wide theatrical release. But in all reality, the way that we pitch it to the investors is that they'll recoup their investment alone off of foreign plus a little bit. And then from there, domestic can just be icing on the cake. Okay. I mean, out of four, it is definitely, we're assuming that one will hit to that degree. But from an investing standpoint, we'll try to at least hedge your bets. So they'll at least definitely get their money back from foreign.
So with the films that you've done and are working on, what have been some of the exciting highlights?
Working with Malcolm. That was one of the highlights of the summer.
How so?
He's just a character, and he's got such great energy on the set, and he's such a professional. He's been doing this a very long time. Mm-hmm. And, it just shows you that, you know, the fun element is always there, and that's where the best work shines. So,
any thoughts for you?
It was a great year. I brought in the financing for a $2 million project, and then slayed a dragon as the lead, and met this guy. Our production company is kicking. I feel very blessed. By definition, I have such a long ways to go, so it's very humbling to be here in the presence of like all the level 8 major studios and whatnot. But just as long as you keep going and tenacity, I think that's like the key.
So how many times have you, both individually and collectively, this will be the first time together at AFM, but prior to this, have you been to AFM before?
When we had Lauren Cass, prior to us getting the limited theatrical, I came for a one day to meet and greet through our sales agent. And then last year I came back just to like rub elbows, but I wasn't like actually here in the capacity that I am this time. So it feels different.
And you?
And it's my first time, Kurt.
So you're kind of like on the maiden voyage here.
Yeah.
How's it feel?
It's great. It's I'm really excited. I came into, doing film from wakeboarding.
He's a pro wakeboarder, X Games.
Really?
So yeah, wakeboarding is how I got into film, and I feel like I'm in a great, an exciting position, and things are happening, and I feel very, very lucky, and it's exciting stuff.
So for someone who's never been here before,
yeah,
a first timer like yourself,
yes,
how does it compare from what you envisioned here to what is going on?
To be honest, it's
no lie to us, please.
To be honest, it's very structured. Mm-hmm. As opposed to when you go to Sundance or other things like that. But to be honest, I really I'm enjoying it. We've been here 2 days, but I like the structure of it, and I'm learning a hell of a lot. So it's a great opportunity.
Okay. And for you, who has done this more than once at the park, what's your thought?
I just think it's great to have a forum like this where you can bring all the elements together. Especially, you can get a sales agent to vet the best domestic relationships, but as far as foreign distributors, to have everybody all under one roof, and you can go out to the events in the evenings and meet and greet in that respect, and then you can also try to track them down. They're the ones wandering around.
Absolutely.
But yeah, I just think it's such a great thing that they offer to independent producers.
Congratulations to both of you. I wish you huge
Thank
success.
You so much,
Thanks, Kat.
It's so good to see
it's
you
great
again.
To see you.
I'm so glad to see you so well.
Oh, it's great to meet you.
Thanks for having us.
All right. I'm Kurt Kelly for Actors Reporting Live Video Inc., and we'll be back with more in a moment.